tell you this. When Hunter Campbell told me that he was looking at her negative or her positive COVID test, I said, okay. Obviously, I said more than okay. And then I don't want to get into particulars because about, you know, put a fist through the wall. The next day, an article came out from her wife stating that they had been locked down for, you know, 11 days and that they both, all three of them tested negative and that they were all clear and that they were all ready to go. And so I saw them like the next day in the gym and like training and everything like that. And so they were posting this stuff. And I just had a feeling it wasn't going to happen in general, because every time she's posting, it's like chocolate cake and, you know, all sorts of goodies that you normally wouldn't be eating in a fight camp. So I was just like, she's just probably on the couch eating chocolate cake and was like, what, the fight's next week? Oh no, no, I got COVID, like, we're not, like, she probably just wasn't ready, you know what I mean? So it is what it is. And now, you know, I had words with her head coach down in Houston, Dan Lambert, whom flew me down to Vegas or to Florida and, you know, had me up on South Beach and, you know, rented me a car to drive around and train in their gym. So I know Dan well. And I'm like, Dan, what's up? You know, and he was like, no, she's sick. And I said, that's funny that you say that, because I have a source in the gym, your gym, who literally told me she hasn't been training for this fight at all. They haven't seen her in the gym at all. And like, he stopped, his wheels start turning, and he's like, No, she's been training. I'm like, all right, Dan, whatever. And then he walked away. You know, we said, you know, whenever the fight was going to be made. And then right after that, the next day, that was a Sunday, she's in the gym, and I've been seeing her in the gym every single day ever since. So I think that really lit a fire under her butt.
Wow.
And, you know, that's the tea on my side.
Okay. Wow. This is a lot of tea right here. You just poured out for us. So Joanna, number one, the thing about Dan, just to be clear, when he got you the car and everything, that was a while ago, right? You're saying you had a relationship.
That was when I won the Ultimate Fighter, when everyone was down in that gym shooting their butts with steroids. Yeah, that was that era.
What are you talking about?
That's literally what their head coach told me. Like, they were welcoming me into the gym, and he was like, the girls shoot themselves in the ass in the bathroom. They do it to each other. And I'm like, no, they don't. And he was like, I swear to God, they're all on steroids. I'm like, what? I literally didn't believe him. And he was literally like, shake me in the head. Like, I promise they're doing it.
Wait, was that part of the sales pitch?
Yeah, exactly. I was like, get me the hell out of here. So that was my experience when I trained at American Top Team. But that was pre-USADA, so I'll say that.